At the height of the third term debate, the apparent architect, King Cobra Michael Sata, was quoted by members paused as saying, anti-third term group doomed. The front page headline of Wednesday 2nd May 2001 also showed a picture of Sata in a plump and very jovial mood and of course looking very authoritative. Authoritative indeed, because he was the all too powerful national secretary of the ruling movement for multi-party democracy and minister without portfolio in Frederick Chiluba's administration.
Hello, Chanda Chimba III here. Welcome to Stand Up for Zambia. In this edition, I'm attempting to take a critical look at the undoubtedly populist leader of the Patriotic Front, Michael Chilufya Sata, also known as the King Cobra.
Anti-third term group Sata was referring to consisted of 22 very senior members of the ruling party, who eventually had enough and formed the Forum for Democracy and Development, FDD, and the Heritage Party, HP. You will agree that the number 22 kind of follows Sata like no one's business. Currently, he has 22 rebel members of parliament to deal with, and it is a thorn in his diminishing flesh. For most founding members of the ruling MMD, the biggest mistake that ever happened to the party that toppled Kenneth Kaunda's United National Independence Party, UNIP, in the first ever multi-party elections in 17 years was to elect Sata to the position of National Secretary. Sata was elected National Secretary at the 1995 MMD Convention, taking over from Brigadier General Godfrey Miyanda. Little did people know that the rolling eyes of the Cobra would hypnotize almost the entire rank and file of the MMD. It was indeed the beginning of terror in the way the party was to be administered. Suspensions and expulsions became the norm, and the party was to be run with an iron fist, with no order, and yet this is the man who claims he can run the country as president better than anyone has ever done. One of the early casualties was Anderson Kambela Mazoka, who by then was branch treasurer in Bauleni. Within 2 years, Sata appeared to have consolidated his grip on running the MMD his own way. His critics say that he simply went on rampage to make sure that anybody with a semblance of leadership was to be viciously hounded out of the MMD. Like I have already indicated, Mazoka was one of the very first people to taste the venom of the Cobra. In a letter dated 7th August 1997, addressed to Mr. Frederick Chiluba, President of the Republic of Zambia, on an MMD letterhead and signed by Sata, a copy of which is shown here, it is clear the Cobra had schemed up something against Mazoka. Some of the contents of this letter are: Dear Mr. President, my findings have revealed that Mr. Mazoka has spent a lot of money on his branch to carry out his hidden political agenda. I am told he has a large following, which may help him reach his presidential aspirations. It goes on to say, he is using a small group of people, whose names I will forward to you soon, to execute his political tasks on the Copper Belt, Lusaka, Northwestern, Western, Luapula and Central provinces. Sata further wrote, the first step, Mr. President, is to instruct the NEC to pass a resolution to dissolve his branch in which he is treasurer on grounds that the branch has not been registered with my office, the Secretariat. According to Sata, dealing with Mazoka in the way he was proposing would keep Andy a distance away from the party and make it difficult for him to influence the people. Sata concluded by saying, I will keep informing you about my progress achieved in this task. It can be deduced from this letter that Sata had set out to hurt Mazoka. Well, the rest is as you may know. Mazoka moved on to form his own political party, the United Party for National Development, UPND, which was launched in 1998. It now beats me how the man who took over from Mazoka could be wining and dining with Sata. Is it not a ploy to continue undermining the Mazoka vision? No wonder the pact isn't working and just cannot work, because Mazoka must be turning in his grave. Evidently so, his soul may not rest in peace. In order to consolidate his grip on running the MMD, Sata is said to have introduced all sorts of draconian rules so as to keep at bay anyone who had left on their own or had been expelled but rejoined in less than 2 years. Regulation number 6 of a memo dated 16th October 1997, signed by Sata, a copy of which is shown here and addressed to all commissioners, provincial chairmen, provincial secretaries, provincial coordinators, and district organizers, is very clear. No member of the party who has been readmitted to the party in less than 2 years shall aspire to any party election at any level. This was a well-calculated move indeed, and for some reason, everyone in the National Executive Committee of the MMD seemed okay with it, or were they hypnotized by the eyes of the King Cobra? Almost 1 year later, on 5th October 1998, in a letter addressed to Honorable Michael Mabenga, Member of Parliament, Deputy Minister, Western Province, and a copy of which is shown here, Sata threatened to discipline Mabenga within 14 days. Sata's threats were regarding a letter Mabenga is said to have written to the President, and it reads in part, Dear Honorable Mabenga, on 13th August 1998, you wrote a letter to the President in which you leveled several serious allegations against the Provincial Executive Committee of Western Province. Mr. Deputy Minister, as Member of Parliament, you are a member of the District Executive Committee and a member of the Constituency Executive Committee. The allegations you made against the provincial officials and myself are contrary to the party constitution, regulation number 7, B, F, G, and J. I am giving you 14 days in which you should show cause why disciplinary action should not be taken against you. But reading through this letter, it was clear that Sata was not happy about the fact that his presidential ambitions had been laid bare in Western Province. Sata alleged that Mabenga had on 28th September 1998 met the Vice President together with 8 other provincial deputy ministers and reported that Sata, the National Secretary, was campaigning for the presidency in Western Province. Critics say Sata may have further been infuriated as he claimed this particular allegation was not reported to the President in the letter of 13th August 1998. In his continued hypnosis of the MMD National Executive Committee, Sata's most probable grand achievement of all was the suspension and subsequent expulsion of Ben Mwila, BY as he is fondly known. BY was MMD National Treasurer and Minister, Environment and Natural Resources at the time. But many, including Sata, considered him a formidable force in view of the fact that Chiluba's 2 5-year terms would end in 2001. Those that were close to Sata attest to the fact that the Cobra breathed a sigh of relief when BY was finally expelled at the NEC meeting held at State House. For Sata, the way was now as clear as could be, and for him, it meant putting the third term talk in overdrive. Chiluba hadn't really come out publicly to say he would go against the country's constitution, or indeed have it amended to seek a third term in office. All the politicking was left to Sata, in fact believed to have been the architect of the whole thing of the third term. It is said Sata conceived the idea, knowing too well that Chiluba would not seek a third term and hoped that his loyalty would earn him all the favors and Chiluba would anoint him his successor. But according to Edwin Lifwekelo, the first Secretary General of Sata's Patriotic Front, this party was actually formed in 2000, long before the 2001 polls. He claims there were a lot of behind-the-scenes maneuverings, as it appeared Sata had a feeling he would be let down by Chiluba.
Chanda Chimba, I want to tell you that the owners of the Patriotic Front apparently are University of Zambia students. Those are the people that personally went to, spoke to, when we were establishing the party, and then of course the party was born. Yeah, the party was established in 2000, of course, prior to the election in 2001, and apparently I was the first general secretary of the Patriotic Front. Having formed the party, having recruited the membership from the University of Zambia, bringing on board, of course, the students that came on board to ensure that the principles and values that all of us believed then, inculcated in the Constitution, standing for those values and hoping that, of course, eventually we are going to be able to provide the leadership. But alas, alas to say that, of course, our anticipations and anxieties were thwarted by what is going on in the party.
Asked whether Sata, as National Secretary of the MMD and Cabinet Minister then, was operating an underground clandestine movement right under the nose of his boss Chiluba, this is how Lifwekelo responds.
Yes, indeed, I can confess to you that we started organizing the PF when Mr. Sata was still the National Secretary of the ruling MMD, when he was still Minister without portfolio. That's when we started doing the underground movement.
So this is the man that you people want to be president of Zambia. A man who appeared to show total loyalty, yet he was planning other things right under his boss's nose. This is the same man who sometime in 1993 caused commotion on a British Airways flight 052 from Lusaka to London. Members Weekly Post reported then that Sata's behavior provoked outrage and that he insulted airline officials and passengers on the London flight, like this newspaper excerpt of the Weekly Post edition of September 7 to 23, 1993, plainly shows. Sata is also reported to have caused a lot of confusion in the Lusaka City Council. The Weekly Post edition number 113 of September 3 to 9, 1993, had this as one of its headlines: Lusaka's Great Political Circus. Reading through this article, Sata, who had been transferred from the Ministry of Local Government and Housing to Labour, but also Kabwata Member of Parliament, and the town clerk Winter Kabimba, had taken centre stage. Kabimba was viewed by most councillors as Sata's man. Yes, this article by Masao Supiri revealed telltale signs of wrongdoing and underhand methods not only on Sata, but Kabimba as well. There was the issue of the Nalubuto Road and Independence Avenue houses, hotel bills, and most of all, the contract in relation to the Meza flats in Lusaka's Chilenje township. You see, Sata's scheming and dirty politics go back a long, long way. In the UNIP one-party era, he is said to have gone to an opponent's grocery store somewhere in Lusaka's Chilenje township and bought off all the stocks, which he immediately distributed to his supporters.
According to eyewitnesses, this opponent's shop was left empty, and it remained so for many, many months.
When Mpulungu Member of Parliament Lamek Chiwomba Milimo passed on, Sata issued all sorts of statements, in effect pointing a finger at the Rupia Banda administration as being responsible for the MP's passing. Yet Sata was in 1994 said to have been behind the dirty tricks that led to Chiwomba Milimo losing his position as MMD Lusaka Provincial Secretary. It is believed that the two could actually not see eye to eye, and it remained so for a long time. I doubt if there was any reconciliation. Right now, Sata's Patriotic Front is embroiled in a serious feud with Hakainde Hichilema's United Party for National Development, in a relationship referred to as the PFUPND Pact. From the time it was heard that these two parties were getting into such an arrangement, those that knew Sata could only laugh. Today, it is as clear as a fine October morning that this pact is in real, real trouble. Critics are simply putting it this way. If you want to know whether two Dobermans, Alsatians or mongrels lying side by side are in good books, just throw a bone in one direction and boy oh boy, you will be shocked how they will run for that bone and fight to a point where the third Doberman, Alsatian or mongrel, which had nothing to do with their fight, will simply pick the bone and go away. By the time the other two are through with fighting, licking their wounds in the process, all they will be able to pick up is the scent of the bone. The pact is being described in this manner by some people I'm getting in contact with who say they are keen followers of Stand Up for Zambia. Others are simply wondering if a ruffian or lumpen and a gentleman can really coexist. The PFUPND pact is also being referred to as a double-headed snake, with hardcore critics calling it a gay marriage which can't bear fruit. One person actually made me laugh when he said, "You see, Chanda, in the world of Adam and Eve, you are able to see fruitful results. But this PFUPND pact is like those gay marriages we hear of which basically do not bear any fruit. That is why it will never work." One thing that we all ought to bear in mind and always remember is that Zambia is not about two tribes, Tonga and Bemba. No matter how big they may be perceived to be, Zambia is run by 73 tribes and perhaps a little more, all working together for Mother Zambia. Now, if Sata and Hichilema think they can get to State House riding on the tribe factor, they are wasting their time, resources and energies. Remember, Sata, as the all-too-powerful National Secretary of the MMD, smeared venom on all who had a semblance of leadership so he could clear his way to the top. He was pretty sure he had succeeded, but yes, there was a sleeping giant somewhere who was awoken, and that, in my view, is a clear indication that Sata will never be president of this country. I'm pretty sure God has a plan for this country, and only He knows the reasons why Sata has been rejected 3 times in democratically run elections. But it appears both Sata and Hichilema have great appetite for State House, to the effect that they are failing to run their own parties. As opposed to what Sata's and Hichilema's lieutenants are on record as saying, the pact is not driven by the people, but by Sata and Hichilema. In the run-up to both the 2006 and 2008 elections, Sata and Hichilema were at each other's throats like no one's business. Yes, like two Dobermans fighting for the highly prized bone. It is said that when a cobra spits in your eyes, you naturally close them, and in the process you lose direction. Hichilema has been described by his critics as having lost direction politically. Hardliners in the UPND say in no uncertain terms that if Mazoka was still traversing this world we live in today, chances of him bringing the UPND in a pact with Sata's PF would have been extremely slim or none at all. Some analysts also predict that when all is said and done, Hichilema will be in the political intensive care unit and Sata will escape with minor bruises. The PFUPND pact is nothing but the Tower of Babylon. No sugarcoating of any sort will prevent it from crumbling. It's all there to see.
Well, that's it for this edition of Stand Up for Zambia. But be sure to join me next time. I'm Chanda Chimba III. I'll see you soon.